He says there's no Trojan horse either. He's not quite sure what is going on. George Galloway is with us now, the Respect MP for Bradford West. Do you know what's going on, George?
Well, I think I know part of what's going on, and it is, as Councillor Khan just said, an attempt by the local education authority to find scapegoats for their own dismal performance.
They're not here to answer that, George, but if they were, I'm sure that they would deny that.
Well, no. Well, I don't think there's any argument that Bradford is in the relegation zone in national school league tables. In fact, we have the 10th worst schools in the entire country. We're 140th in the league out of 150. And that's a fact that cannot be disputed. And if I were presiding over such a failed system with so many weaknesses, I'd be looking for other people to blame also. And I think that there is a class within the education system and the education establishment, if you like, who don't really like uppity parents subjecting them to forensic, sometimes withering, criticism and questioning. And I think that in this case, the Laisterdyke case, that's all that the Board of Governors were doing. And their prize has been, as you've just said, wholesale sacking. And then someone, somewhere, and you haven't yet established it on your program, whispered a connection to the Trojan horse allegations in Birmingham. And the only connection between Bradford and the Trojan horse allegations in Birmingham is that many of the governors involved, as indeed many of the pupils, though not as many of the teachers or head teachers as there should be, are Muslims. And this kind of smearing of people is adding insult to the very considerable injury
that
children in Bradford have already suffered.
But if this issue, this Trojan horse issue, raises the concerns that Councillor Khan has, that you clearly agree with, I'm sure Bradford Education Authority would be arguing that if they were here or they were asked. If it's raising a bigger issue, George, isn't that to the well and good? Or is all this speculation about Trojan horses harmful?
It's very harmful because it intimidates parents from coming forward to put themselves up as governors. It intimidates governors from doing the job they're supposed to be doing for fear of being accused, not just of being an extremist, but worse, part of a conspiracy of extremists that is being investigated by the former anti-terrorism commander, no less, in the form of Commander Clark, whose appointment was deplored by the Chief Constable.
You don't think there's any question marks then over...
Well, I'm bound to tell you, and time will tell, but remember, you heard it here. I think the entire Trojan horse story is a hoax. And I think that the revelation of that fact will be extremely damaging to David Cameron when Commander Clark reports.
And why are you so sure of that? Why are you so sure?
Well, I have documents in my possession, as they say.
Which documents?
I can't, because of sub judice issues, go into them. I'm just saying to you, remember you heard it here, that the Trojan horse allegations, in my view, are a hoax. Anonymous papers circulating, naming people in this way for quite different reasons than those purported. But that's a different matter. The using this Trojan horse shadow is, I think, intended to intimidate Muslim parents from coming forward and governors from being hot on the tail of the poor performance that many local education authorities are involved in. And that's why it's deplorable, because we need to get more parents coming forward. We need governors who are less of a rubber stamp and more of an interrogator. It's like anything else, Liz. If you or I worked for a committee, we'd kind of rather, as individuals, prefer a committee that didn't give us a hard time. But giving the paid officials a hard time is what the committee's supposed to do.
And will you...
Thus you get accountability.
All right, will you be able to reveal the documents that you have that prove that the Trojan horse is a myth at some point?
At some point I will, but I suspect that Commander Clark will reveal them first, because I suspect that he already knows that it's all been a hoax.
Thank you very much. George Galloway, the Respect MP for Bradford West, as we've been trying to expose and get to the truth of what's going on at Laisterdyke. It's 8:20.
West Yorkshire Travel.
BBC Radio Leeds.
Here's David.